Hello friends, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Today we are going to create a simple block within 10 or 15 minutes. So let's see. Now you know blog is just a simple website that displays information as a communication tool between a person that is a blogger and also the people who watch. Okay. Now let's say an example here. You see, we have a lot of templates that we can use. Now Bootstrap made as my favorite place for grabbing free templates. It gives us a nice template that we can use, and that is what we are going to download and utilize it in our Blazor application. No matter the kind of model that you are using, either the Blazor WebAssembly or the Blazor Web Server, it still works. You can still implement this. You can still implement this template in Blazor. So let's get going. Now let's download it. So come to bootstrapme.com/the kind of template that we're going to use here is what that's it. ZenBlock Bootstrap template. So that is this ZenBlock. So click on this or grab this line here. Grab it over here, free download, click on it. Now you see I have downloaded it already. So it is over here under my compressed. It is here. So as you can see, when you download it, you're going to have it in this format. Okay, so I also leave the source code in the description, also the link to this website as well. So you can just go in there, grab it, and also click on it, also download it in case you wanted to do that. Now, this is for education purpose, so I'm not doing this to sell, because you know, when you go to their free template, they ask you not to send it to people or not sell it, and you know, this is for education purpose, so I think I am granted. Okay, so let's open this, let's extract. So I'm going to extract this. Now we are doing this like 10 or 15 minutes. So there is a application that we have now. Okay, now if I open this, let's see what happens. So that's the index. So if I open this, that is the index here. So this is a simple block that you want to implement in Blazor. For now, you see that it is in, that is a normal one, and we want to implement all of these in Blazor. Okay. So how can you do this? Let's see. Let's create our Blazor WebAssembly or server. Let's create a server project. Okay. Because that is what we don't have any server attached to. So let's say I have a Visual Studio and I'm going to launch it from the administrator mode. So we create a new projects and you're going to look for Blazor server. So server is right here. If you not click on this and then go to Blazor, that is it. You see, have Blazor server here. Click on next and here it is. Let's say Blazor server dot blog or my Blazor server blog. So that is the name. This is the location. Click on next. And also we choose the framework 7.0 is okay for us. Click on this, create, and then we have this created. So let's see. Now when you open, we open our folder, you see we have this. Now these are the assets. So this asset, as you can see from here, we have a CSS, images, everything over here. So without wasting time, we can just grab this asset. We come to our solution explorer. So where you have our WW root folder, let's paste this asset here. So when you open it, you see we have everything, CSS, variables, as you can see, images used for the project. We have our JavaScript. We have also this Bootstrap and etc. Okay. Now the next thing to do here is let's open our index. So open this. I'm going to open weight. With this Sublime test. So I have this Sublime, open it with it. Now you see that is it. So here we have our CSS. So what you're going to do here is you're going to grab this CSS here. And there's a font. So you can start to add the font or you can just skip it. Okay. So but make sure you have internet connection before you add the font, because you see as soon as it has HTTPS, it means it has to go online. But what I'm going to do here is basically offline. So Solution Explorer, now I go to pages and we have host.php.html. Now let's paste the link over here. That's where we have our links. You can paste it over here. So we have this link here. Now the next thing here to do is check we can have our images, so our favorite icon too. So let's grab that. Like you see, with default, we have the favorite icon here. So we can comment this favorite icon as a favicon. You can comment it right here and you can paste this. So let's paste our favicon here, and that's our favorite icon. Okay. Now the next thing to do is, as we are done with this, let's see, we have to include our JavaScript. So with the down here, where we have the endpoint, we have a JavaScript, and that is where we need to grab them from. So we actually don't need any form here because we're not going to use form. We're going to create our own. So we can grab this. Then we go to where we have our scripts. We paste them here. Then the next one, the last one left here, our main, that is the heart of the project, or that is the heart of the template. So we put it over here as well. Now the next thing to do is also quite simple. Once you have this and that already, let's have our footer and our header. So let's see, our header is here. So as you can see, this is our header. Okay, so we can grab this header from this area. Now let's go to our components. You see, we have a default component in here, so I'm going to edit this and I'll type in header, but I really want to put them under the shed. So instead of this nav menu, I can put this header here. So that is the header. Now in here, I'm going to paste what I have. Okay, so I paste this here, I'll save it. Let's go and grab the footer too. So this is the main. Now the footer will be around here. So this is our footer ending, starting, and that's the end. So we can also grab this footer. Now in the solution, we also have one here, survey prompt. So we can also skip that and now say this footer. And now in here, let's paste it, let's save it. Now we have our header and footer. Let's utilize it in our project. So we go to main layout.cs. And now I want us to make a copy of this. Let's paste it here. And now let's highlight or let's comment this. So in here, this is what we're going to do. We have our main, and we're going to skip this. We're going to also remove the sidebar. So in here, we have our header. So let's have our header. So when our time is almost 10 minutes, you alert me because we want to finish it 10 minute time. So we have our header, then we have body over here, then we have our footer. Now let's run this application and see what we have now. So header and footer, we have asset length. So whilst we wait for, okay, so we have an error here. Now what are the errors here? So we see, oh, we have to get connected to internet and to update these packages. All right, so I've connected to my Wi-Fi and I have internet now. So let's go and build the project. So right click here and now let's build solution. So you can see down here, restore packages, and it is done quickly. Now when you go to the CS, or that's the HTML file, you see we have bootstrap, default bootstrap link already. So we can also comment that. So Control K and C, we can comment that bootstrap. Now let's run this application again and see the outcome of this. So this is a simple blog that we are creating using a bootstrap template that we downloaded online. Okay, so let's wait and see. Oh, okay, so beautifully and nicely well presented. So you can see we have everything. So that is it. And all these, there are buttons that we can actually go in for. So you can see we have over here, that's the logo, and we have this, that's the footer. We have our header over here, so we have our sets. Now we have all this. Now what is the next thing to do? Let's grab an index. So let's go to our page here, and I can see from here the next thing that we can talk about, let's try that and see. So we have our header, and that's our, this is our slider. So when you check the template itself, you can see that, okay, so you see we have this image here and we have this also. before you come to the cutter. So we can decide to display this and the first one. Okay, so let's see how to grab this. So the first one, that is the slider. So we're going to comment this as slider, and that's a post grid section. So post grid section comprised of the trending and this catcher. Now let's try that to see. So it contains the catcher, that is it. So we can quickly, we can grab this. And now let's go to our project. So where we have this counter, you can now edit this counter, and now let's click the debugging. So let's set it. Now here is going to be home. Okay, so with this home that I have here, I'm going to paste it here, save. Now this is what I'm going to do. Now you see, when you go to the index, now the index comprises of this. So I'm going to clear all this. I don't need any of this for now. Then I'm going to implement the home. That is it. Now let's run this and see. Once you run it, we can also check the other ones too. So we see from this template, from the old one, we see we have also this culture, and we can also put this somewhere else. Business, we can put this somewhere else, and we see there's a lifestyle. So you see these are all tabs. Now you can put them under categories. So you can just grab the business and put under business. You can grab categories, and that's a lifestyle, and put them as a lifestyle. Okay. Let's see, our time is almost up, and I'm going to check how many minutes. Oh, it's almost 11 minutes 52 seconds. Can we make it like 20 or 15 minutes? Yeah, let's see. So we come here, you can see we have, it is a template. Now let's go through the project. What is our project? Okay, so that's our project, Blazor server blog. Okay, so you can see we have a nice project over here. Wow, so that is it. Our 10 minutes is up. If you want us to continue on with this, you can let me know. But I know we know how to implement a template in Blazor WebAssembly. So these are the features that you have. You see, we couldn't do all. We have a lot, but because of our time, we said 10 minutes, we have to finish it up. All right, so that is it for this video. Also, I'll leave the link to the template over there, that is in blog and the description. So you can click on it to grab it for free. Thank you so much for watching and being part of this family. See you guys in the next video.